Campbell with another 1,000 bits. He said, easy one, then, to get us back on track. Favorite part of Texas so far? Honestly, man, this question's honestly a little too innocent for me. It's a little too vanilla, but I'll give you a good answer. I think my favorite part of Texas so far is just the house in general, man. Like, the home is such a better setup that we're in now compared to the last for me to stream. And I'm telling you, I don't know how you guys feel. Maybe I'm a bit of a pussy, but I'm just going to tell it like it is. When our house in LA got, when my car got broken into, a guy walked up my fucking driveway, threw a brick through my Porsche window, and then he tried to get into the house, bro. He tried to open multiple doors, and I think just seeing that on the cameras and having the footage from it, it really, really changed the dynamic of that home. You know, I've got a kid now. My wife at that time was very pregnant, and I just did not feel comfortable in that house anymore. Every night I would think about that moment. Every night I would think about what would happen if somebody tried to get in. And it just put like a dark cloud over this place that for a while felt like our home. And it kind of ruined the image in my everyday life in that house. So now with a fresh start in Texas, just this home so far has been phenomenal, man. There's obviously less traffic. You know, it's still a little populated over here, less traffic, a lot of great food spots we've been to. But there's just more room to stretch out my legs, my arms, my feet, and just feel comfortable. So far the best part of Texas is home. But also, yeah, the Southern hospitality. I talked about this the other day. Just the people so far have been nicer, man. I'm really big on people like treating each other with respect, and it might sound dramatic, but quite a few of the places I've already been to so far, just working with somebody that I need a service from, like going to the car dealership, going to the grocery store, talking to strangers. Everybody just, their natural disposition, it's like the edge has been taken off and they got a smile on their face. They talk to you. All of our neighbors have come and introduced themselves. Like, we didn't know any of our fucking neighbors in California. Nobody. The only thing that happens with our neighbors in California is people just in a WhatsApp group talking about all the crime happening. There's fucking helicopters flying around 24/7, people getting broken into homes, dogs being snatched up. Out here, bro, we've had like 5 neighbors bring over bundt cakes and fucking handshakes. It's been unbelievable. It's electric out here. So I just feel very welcome, and I feel very at home. So Campbell, Wangs, guys, thanks for the 1,000 bits from both of you gentlemen. Very different questions, very different answers, but you doped me up all the same. We love you guys to death. Yo, Hidden Squid, I'm so sorry that I had the longest fucking answers. I basically took the entire length of the Bible, every chapter, and crammed it into those answers. Those gentlemen, I didn't mean to, you know, edge you a little bit. Brother, thank you so much for the 5 gifted, brother. The gifted subs here keep this stream alive, brother. So thank you so much, Hidden. You're the man. We appreciate you. A Hidden Squid, give me a bib and we'll eat some ocean creatures or something together. I don't fucking know. I don't know what squids do, but I love you to death. You're hidden. I can't even find you. Thanks for the 5 gifted. Lee Taylor, thanks for the 16 months, buddy. Ray Pax, thanks for the 2 months. K.R. Reed, or K. Reed, he said, yeah. Thanks for the 4 months, brother. Bugzer, thank you very much for the 2 months. He said, yes, sir. Love Texas. Florida repping over here. Come on now, Bug. And then Casella hit me with a gifted sub as well. Thank you so much. W. Chatter coming right over the top. Right over the top of this squid who's hidden, man. He said 5 more gifted to you there, Nadeshot. Thank you, Chatter. Thank you. That is a W Chatter, man. W Chatter. We love you to death. What kind of tips would you give someone like me for a first-time father having a daughter? Yo, 0 to the left, man. Sounds like you might be having children soon. I got bad news, bro. Unless your question is attached to 1,000 bits, I can't answer it, man. Sorry. There's a 15-second delay on today, so I'm sorry. I'm going to stop this bit before it even begins. My monitor just flickered. Why did it do that? First-time advice, man. I've answered this question a few times. Yo, listen to me. Your job really is to be patient with your wife. or your significant other, whoever's having the baby. You know, it's biologically, there's not a lot we can do, but physically and mentally, like, we can be just great companions to our partner. Or what, my wife was really carrying the boats in a lot of ways. Make sure you have your hospital bag ready. My wife had that prepared, obviously. I haven't done many things productive. But, you know, the baby can come early. You want to have the hospital bag packed. If you're going to the hospital, one of the things I would pack in that bag are the, you know, those eye masks so that you can sleep during the daytime, because you're going to try to have to sleep when the baby's asleep. It's going to be very chaotic, but it's like a calm chaos, you know, knowing that you're going through it together with the love of your life or whoever you're having your child with. Your whole job is just to be patient, bro. You're just there to be like a support player for your wife. So that's the best I could give. Just be patient, man. That's really what it comes down to. You know, just by nature, man, there's not many things that we can do to fucking facilitate the pregnancy, but we got it easy, man. We're on easy street, brother. You got to remember, too, as soon as the baby have, you know, hormones are changing, their brains are getting crashed with all different types of emotion, the motherly instinct. You just got to sit there and be patient. Be a support player, brother. Any wedding advice? Just sent my invites to the printers. It's next February. Some people might like this advice. Some people might not. I saw a couple of people do this on TikTok, and I wish I would have done the same. Bro, at the welcome party for your wedding, or if you're just doing a reception, I would basically just tell everybody, hey, listen, we love you to death. You know, you guys are our closest friends and family. That's why we invited you, and we're overwhelmed with joy, and just we feel very loved that you guys came. But what we're going to do is we're going to just float around, enjoy our night, enjoy our moment, just as man and wife, husband and wife. If you guys want to come say hi, come up to us and say hello, feel free, but don't feel required. You know, when you have a wedding and you invite people, it's kind of like the underlying courtesy to go say hi to each individual group that has come. Like, you got to go work the room. You're basically on the clock saying hi to every single person, having like a fucking 5-minute conversation, then you're on to the next. It's really hard to enjoy the moment with your wife. Like, if you're going to spend all the money to have this fucking day and this celebration, you got to be able to enjoy it. So if there's anything that I would have done differently, I would have gone back and just told everybody the same thing that I just told you guys, because it's harder to really like live in the moment when you feel like you're just on the clock, just trying to work the room. You know, the other thing I would say is the quintessential advice that everybody gives, it goes by really quickly, man. So try to enjoy it. Sit down, take a moment with your wife, soon to be wife, and just talk about everything that led you to this moment. You know, try to do some things that will put some pins in the memory bank so you can remember it better. It goes by really quickly, brother. It really, really does. So enjoy, man. This is the good part. This is the best parts of growing up, man. Enjoy it.